Welcome to today's coffee break. Today we're going to talk about the recurring journals. I often find that people don't utilize the recurring journal functionality, and I think it's fantastic, and I think everyone should use it. So I just want to give you sort of a little teaser here of how it's used, and then you, of course, can test it out and see if it works for you. So the recurring journals are located under finance, under periodic activities, and under the general ledger, and here's the task, recurring general journals. So what I've done here is I have different batches of journals. I have my utilities, let's say, that come in the first week of the month, and then maybe I do another one for the third week of the month. So any invoices that I'm anticipating I'm receiving, I can sort of queue them up in the recurring journals. And that also lets me know if I'm missing something. Maybe I didn't receive an invoice and I need to go follow up with my vendor. So I'm just going to show you my utilities here. So I already have this set up for my week one utilities that I'm looking for, and I have some variation here. So I have my recurring method, and in this case, I have my invoice from my postage. And I'm going to say, you know, we pay for this every month, and it varies. So this is going to be a variable amount, as opposed to my lease, which is a fixed amount every month. So you have these different options, fixed, which just means that the amount will remain the same from month to month to month. You can always override it, but the default will be the same amount. Variable, actually, when you post it, the dollar amount will turn to zero, and it's going to wait for you to create the amount every month so you don't accidentally post the same amount, the same dollar amount. Balance, this actually gives you the option of posting the balance of a GL account. So if you want to use this for accruals, you can use it for that as well. And then of course we have reversing fixed, reversing variable, and reversing balance, which will create a reversing entry for the next date. Then we have our recurring frequency. And in this case, I have 1M for 1 month. It could be 3M if you wanted to do it quarterly. It could be 7D for 7 days. So you can use any of the standard date structures that Navision recognizes. And as I said, in this case, it's 1M. And what will happen is when I do my posting, it's going to roll the posting date forward 1 month because of that recurring frequency. Then I have my document type, and in this case, it's invoice. And I have my document number. So what you can do here is you can use these little codes that will, I'm just making a correction here. Let's see here. What happens with these codes is this will remain the same, the year and the document number. However, this %4 will actually get recreated on the posting with the month. That way I get a unique document number for each of my postings. So this will always say the year, the type of document it is, and then the month. And as we go through the year, this will just increment in our postings. Again, we want a unique document number, and this way I don't have to think about it. Of course, if the vendor gives you a document number that is unique, you'll want to use that, or you'll want to use the external document number column to capture that information. So here I have my account type, which in this case is vendor. You also have all the other major account types. The other one you would see in here frequently would be GL account, and that would be for posting the balance of the GL account for your accruals. Then I have my account number, so I have selected my different vendors here, and my amount. So in this case, we're going to pretend that we've paid, I don't know, $100 for postage. And this has something kind of neat in the background in that I put in my invoice for $100. And back here under allocations, this is where I'm going to put my balancing information, my balancing account. So if I click on allocations, I see here that I have my account, my expense account for my postage, which is fine. But I've also selected my dimension for my department. And I'm able to come in here and say, okay, my administrative department is 60% of the postage. And my sales department makes up 40% of the postage. And immediately when I put in this dollar amount of $100, it distributed the amount according to that percentage. So let's just do that again so I can show you. There we go. And now we look at our allocations and you see now that administrative is 120 and sales is 80. So once you've set it up in the background, you really only need to put that dollar amount on that first page. on the general journal line, and it will populate the allocations for you automatically based on that percentage. You could also do a quantity if you wanted, but I often see the allocation done by percentage, so that's what I'm going to show you. I click OK, and let's say I also got my phone bill. Nice even numbers. And I have here my lease, which is the same amount, and I have an expiration date. So this expiration date, this is when my lease is up, and this will prevent me from accidentally, you know, paying the same amount when maybe there was a change that needs to be addressed. So once you've got everything set up and you've put in your variable amounts, you go ahead and post. And I'm out of balance because I didn't put any allocations on this account. So here we go, my balancing account. Let's do 33, 33, and 34. All right, and now I see my allocated amount has been distributed accordingly, and I'm gonna go ahead and try that post again. Okay, so now if I look over here, I see that my posting date rolled forward 1 month, and I see those lines that are marked as variable dollar amounts are now zero, but conveniently it's left the allocated amount so I could see what it was last time, which is kind of handy because if there's a huge disparity from your last month, you might wanna look into it. So it does keep that information for you. And of course, my fixed amount stays the same. So now the next month comes, you put in the new invoice amount, and you'll see that the allocated amount changes accordingly. And that's it. It's very simple. Once you set it up, it's very easy to use. And I hope that you look into using the recurring journals if you're not already doing it. That concludes today's coffee break.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.